Chair, no, we have to. Sir, before I start responding to the bill, I would first like to respond to my dear friend, Sri Jairam Ramesh. Please. He said that please refer it to some committee, Senate committee or standing committee. I have no problem whatsoever. I can give a solemn assurance, provided if the House functions regularly, if the bills are allowed to be discussed and passed, I have no problem at all. All of us can come to that understanding. In the last 1 week, 10 days, we are having a very positive atmosphere, very good atmosphere, and then constructive. I'm just coming. I'm just
coming. Chairman of all committees.
If the suggestion given by Sri Ramesh ji is acceptable to all his friends in that side also, I'll be more than happy, because many of the bills have been referred to standing committees. Standing committee is a committee of both the houses, Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha. Then after that also, we are referring some of the bills to Senate committee. That has to be revisited. I'm not making any comment against anybody, because time question. Second one, once the standing committee clears it, the government of the day, you are all aware, need not bind by whatever the standing committee says. You can accept. Here, for example, the Senate committee made certain recommendations. I have improved upon that Senate committee recommendations also, gone beyond a point by raising it up to 70%. So let us have a healthy precedent. Definitely, sir, the government believes in discussing every issue through the session before that to the standing committee also. Unless there is an extraordinary situation, we should not resort to bypassing the standing committee. I do agree. And if there is something special, there has to be a joint Senate committee, only in such rarest of the rare cases. But at the same time, if I have to follow that principle, whatever is agreed upon by the Senate committee or standing committee, that has to be honored, and it should not be stalled in Parliament. This has to be agreed by one and all. If that is agreed, then I have no problem, sir. I'm more than happy. I understand the spirit of the session given by Sri Ramesh. Second is about the issue raised by Sri Naresh Agarwalji and also my friends from ADMK, raising a basic issue about the legislative competence of the Parliament. Sir, I have already explained in the beginning itself that the Constitution clearly gives the power to Parliament to enact laws in such cases, and the Law Department of Opinion also has confirmed it, and also the Attorney General also has opined that the Parliament is competent enough to legislate on this very important issue. That's my response to my friends in ADMK and also to Mr. Naresh Agarwal, to please understand the rationale and also understand, as you yourself are saying, a lot of things are happening in the real estate sector. That's why the government brought this bill. Please understand that and then try to cooperate. Another important point made by Shailja ji is about the reducing the area below 500. Earlier, you are all aware, it is 1,012. Now, I brought it down to 508. I'd like to bring to the notice of the House, states have the power to reduce it below 500 also. And also, or even 8 apartments also, you can bring it down. This power in this very bill itself is given to the states. So let us leave it to the wisdom of the state, depending on the situation. Situation Mumbai is different, situation Calcutta is different, situation my town, Nellore, is different. So that's why we have left it under a clause 3.2a proviso. It's very clearly mentioned. Then another important point made by Shailja ji and also my friend Raju Gowda is about the discrimination provision. I do agree there are certain instances that have come to our notice through the media. But at the same time, the Constitution is very clear. Article 15 of the Constitution provides for protection against any discrimination, religion or region or sex or whatever it is. Discrimination is totally not allowed. There are remedies also available. Simply reiterating it through another amendment, I don't think will serve any additional purpose, except as a minister, I can say it, and also we can provide it in the rules also, and say, rules also. Yeah.
The that would be very
Yeah, good. I will. Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
One is, I am reiterating that no discrimination can be allowed on the basis of religion, region, caste, or creed, or sex, whatever it is, or on the food habits also. Because you cannot. You can have restriction within your house, what you want to eat and what you want to eat. But at the same time, you can't force others also. But at certain places, some such things are happening. I am reiterating that we are clearly against any discrimination. Secondly, we will consider it, including it in the rules, by making the rules. This is about the important aspects made by...
As if I'm just interrupting. Sir, again I urge upon the Honorable Minister, sir, agar kisi tarah se jo gareeb aur sabse chote tabke ke log hain, ye 500 meter ka bhi hata dein, to ek bahut hi bada kadam hoga inke liye. Bahut bada kadam hoga.
Ma'am, I understand the spirit of your suggestion, but there are practical problems also. That's why earlier it was put 1012, then I'm bringing it to 500 to 8. Once we start implementing it, anytime we can bring change. Moreover, this has attracted my personal attention also. I myself insisted that the power has to be given to the states. At the end of the day, we are dealing with the local bodies and also with the states. Let there be some flexibility given to the states. That's my response to this issue. With regard to the single window or early clearances, I'm talking about the major issues. I'm not going one by one. I have the list of all the speakers' names and also the points they made. I can recall all of them, but that would take time. One of the important factors that was made was, what about the other side? You are giving all these restrictions, putting time limits and all, even for tribunal also, for appellate authority also, I fixed the time. Earlier it was 90 days, now it is 60 days only. But people are asking me, so what about the permissions? You people delay permissions for months and years together, and then you are only trying to fix responsibility on us. So this also, the government have taken it very seriously. We held consultation with the states. Held consultation with the states also. Now, in the Housing for All program, which is an important program of the government, we have made it very clear that there has to be single window clearance. But at the same time, you cannot prescribe it yourself, because permissions, approvals are again in the federal system or with the local bodies. But at the same time, through incentives and disincentives, through the reforms which I am promoting in the Amrut scheme and the Smart City scheme and Housing for All scheme, I am insisting that these approvals has to be there. Sir, Deputy Chairman, sir, I have also taken a meeting of 6 of my colleagues, Civil Aviation Minister, Consumer Affairs Minister, then the Environment Minister, Defence Minister, Culture Minister. Culture Minister, if you want to construct something, somebody was mentioning about NGT order, saying that Chilka Lake within this many kilometers, you can't do anything. And then if there is some archaeological monument there, up to some area, totally prohibited, nobody knows, then you have to come to Delhi. Civil Aviation, if you want to construct a building in Hyderabad or Thiruvananthapuram, you have to come to Delhi for a project and all. I am happy to inform you, sir, all these things are taken care. Now, the ministers, after having exhaustive discussion, we have come to almost some conclusions with regard to single window approval by various ministries, automation of such systems, setting up nodal agencies and empowered committees. For example, civil aviation, colored-coded zoning maps of 13 major airports are available online. And if you want to apply within that, you can file an affidavit and then go ahead with your construction. Nobody need to take any permission. Tomorrow, if you go wrong, then your building liable to be demolished.
Self-certification.
I hope that probably also appreciate this, because he worked as a civil aviation minister. Automated NOC approval system and height clearance operations are issued on 6th January this year. We worked on that for the last 6 months. Then Culture Ministry, online NOC process notified on 5th February. And helped APP heritage bylaws. This also through that Bhavan. You can locate where are you from that restricted protected area. And then you can file a self-certification, and then you can go ahead also. That also has been decided. Third one is defense. Review of ammunition storage policy. The defense ministers instructed all his local area commanders to share the restricted zone details with the municipal bodies. We are not putting on a website because it's a security related matter, but they are being shared by the local area commandants with these local municipalities, so that they, Hyderabad, for example, has got a practical problem. Cantonment is within Hyderabad city. You cannot construct any building without Pune also similar situation. Bangalore is there, other cities also. There also, the defense minister was kind enough to have detailed discussion. Initially, there was some resistance, naturally because of security reasons. At the end of it, this the defense ministry also is reviewing the ammunition storage policy, and then they are going to share the restricted zone details with municipal bodies, and also these permissions are going to be given by the four defense airports by April 2016. These details will be made available also for these major cities which we mentioned. Then with regard to model building bylaw being finalized by ministry in consultation with the Ministry of Environment and Forest, that has become a big issue in this country. Environment is a big issue. My friend is smiling, Mr. Jairam Ramesh. I do agree, we played with nature. The nature is playing with us. So we have to protect the nature. But at the same time, in the name of the nature, you cannot stop everything. And for everything, people have to come all the way and then wait here for months and days together and all. That's why I applaud really my friend Sri Prakash Javadekar. He was so bold enough, had extensive consultation, and certain things he has excluded also. Defense, even the high tension lines. They are in the interest of the country. High tension lines go for one region to another region and all. So certain things he exempted. Other things also he has simplified. Now, after consultation of 6 times together, the Ministry of Environment and Forest also has come to certain conclusions. They are shared with my ministry. Both of them together are shortly going to come, and I am going to release that model building bylaws in consultation with the Ministry for Environment and Forest. They have also, the Environment and Forest has made one condition. We are ready to close our eyes, provided the conditions we put are adopted by the states and include in the municipal bodies for giving permission, then this permission can be given to municipality. Rather than Coimbatore municipality coming to Delhi, they can, but at the same time, the conditions are very strict and they have to be followed. Any violation, action has to be taken. So that much understanding and undertaking they want from those bodies. We are in touch with the states. States are also favorably inclined for that. Then National Building Code 2015, finalized after incorporating Ministry of Urban Development's model building bylaws. For example, C&D, construction and demolition material. If you want to reuse it also, you have to really modify National Building Code. That has been done. And I'm thankful to the Consumer Affairs Minister, to the Honorable Spokesman, to external the
Yes, Mike, please.
About environment concerns. Sir, in India, in city after city, you are going to see reconstruction taking place. An old building will be demolished and a new building will come up. This is not a new feature. And if you are going to seek environmental clearance for each and every reconstruction project within a municipal limit, I understand that certain large projects need to be, you know, cleared environmentally. But every single building above 50 crores, if it has to go, even not to the central government, but even to the state government or to the local authority, it should be left best to the municipal authorities to determine whether they are able to provide the water or the drainage or other functions.
Sir, we are moving in that direction for reconstruction or redevelopment of the existing buildings. I don't think there's any need to come to Delhi to the Environment Ministry. It has to be left to the states and to the local bodies. We are already discussing that issue also. That will be taken care. Sir, with regard to the multiplicity of permissions and regulations, that issue also is raised. Sri Naresh Goyalji said Naresh Agarwalji said that you have a regulation here. You have a NIDA development authority. So those development authorities are for land use, permitting the projects. Whereas this is authority is to see the agreement reached between the seller and buyer, whether it is being implemented or not, the conditions that have been prescribed, whether they are followed or not, or the offer that is made to the people is being respected or not, that is the duty of the regulatory body. So I don't think there is any conflict between this body and that body also. I want that also to be made very clear. Secondly, sir, as Rajiv Chandrasekhar has said, this bill will promote efficiency and enhance competition. It is not anti-business. Let me also make it very clear, the government policy is to encourage private people also in a big way. And we are happy that they are also playing an important role. They are also equal partners in the development of the country. But they have to follow certain regulations. And they have to really, if they want to enhance their own credibility, they have to fulfill the conditions that they themselves are announcing. As someone was saying, you put a nice grazing brochure, good advertisement, sometimes supported by somebody, some icons and all, and you don't live up to the expectation and promise you made. So it's an offense. That's why this punishment. Yeah, see, we government do not want to harass anybody. And why should I harass any builder? I do see what some of the friends said, you are giving punishment, sending them to jail, as if it is a very big crime and all. Cheating people also is a crime, number one. And who are the people involved in this? Ordinary people who have saved their earnings throughout the life. If they are taken for a ride, and if it is not being implemented, then somebody has to come to their rescue. That's why also straight away, first there is a warning, second there is a penalty, and thirdly, if you are willful defaulter and continuously violating the order given by appellate authority, then comes the provision of penal code of punishment of 3 years, etc. Without that, it's not away straight away. If somebody violated, is going to be sent to jail. This perception is wrong. And then again, sir, with regard to flat, FLAT and PLOT, there is a provision in the bill. It takes care of the plot owners also, because the real estate includes plot sale as well as building sale also. So that also has been taken care. Then another point made is, sir, all permissions have to be taken beforehand. After construction, somebody going there and saying that this is not there, that is not there and all, this has to be disgraced. That's why we are saying before commencing the project, he is supposed to obtain all these permissions, and then if he don't do it, then he will be held responsible, he will be taken to task also. Then the what is the definition of the allottee? Ritambaratham Banerjee has said it is covered, and is an exhaustive definition is given C class 2D. It is very clear in that. And then with regard to the other points he made, I have already covered. Then pointed out how people are freed through false advertisement. This also is taken care. False advertisement also comes under the purview. They will also be penalized, and action can be taken against them also. That is also very clear. I think Mankad Ariji has said it. Then the definition of promoter. All government agencies, including my own PSU, will have to register. There is no way, because it's an agreement between two people. You say something, you have to honor it, whether it is my ministry's organization or any other organization. If they want to sell, they have to register themselves. Government should lead from the front and set examples. That's why I don't think that any government will ask for exempting these government-run agencies. The government-run agencies must be more proactive, more answerable, and more accountable than private people. Because you are a government, you are running on a public money. That's why I quoted the example of American Civil Airlines. I didn't name Air India, now because I don't want to discourage the national carrier. Because the response you see here, something happening is, nothing else is offered. Even after 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, delay also, sometimes cancellation of flights also. So we have... if the developer leaves the project halfway, then what? Clause 8 provides that the association of authorities the first right of refusal, and it's only then would the authority try and get the project completed by some other manner. By some other manner. If somebody leaves, there is a practical problems also, somebody leaves the project in between, then the authority can step in also. Then with regard to the development authority versus real estate development regulator authority, the bill provides that the promoter must first take all approvals from the development authority, then only he can register it with this authority, and only after that promoter registers project with the authority, the promoter can sell to the public. Before that, he is prohibited from selling it. Development authorities, as the Nayuda Authority of Huda, Tuda, Huda, Buda, BDA, Huda, all these, they all have their powers. No, we are not encroaching into the powers of the urban development authorities of any state. Then with regard to the real estate regulation authority shall come into picture after getting permissions only. It shall register the promoters and regulate the sale, purchase of real estate and check whether local authority has given them permission or not. Then only the project will be registered, then only he will be allowed to sell. Then with regard to Daveji, of course, has done a great job with the cooperation of the members. He also spoke elaborately. He emphasized the importance of the carpet area. Consumer would know what he or she is paying for. That's the issue. Sir, some people will say, sir, it will put difficulties and all. Need not. The cost will go up. Some people are saying, if you say carpet area, cost will go up. The consumer will be knowing what is the cost. Be fair and then say, if carpet area only means, this is my rate. If he agrees, then he'll purchase. If you don't agree, you'll not purchase. I don't think there is any problem with regard to clear definition of carpet area. Structural defect liability was earlier 2 years. If there is a structural defect, now the liability has been increased to 5 years. The promoter is duty bound to take care of the structural liability, if any. That stringent thing has been brought in because we have experience also where what happened in Chennai with regard to some building which has collapsed earlier also. And then the recent episode of Chennai floods, some of our friends were mentioning. Sir, floods, of course, one is the nature's fury, sudden heavy rain, second, certain dams were full and water has to be released. But the third was when I went around Chennai city after the heavy floods, lot of people told me, sir, this unauthorized encroachments, unauthorized constructions have added to our problems. This is what large number of people have. But this can be checked not by real estate development regulator authority. It can be checked by a local development authority and urban local body. So we have to sensitize those bodies. As an urban development minister, I have a responsibility also. After Chennai floods, I had an internal discussion in my ministry, and we are now in the process of sending guidelines to the states also with the experience in mind of what has happened in Chennai in the recent past. Then with regard to Clause 3 provides for registration in phases also. The developer can register it in phases because at a time he may not be able to go for the entire project. The bill does not overtake or override the provisions of the Urban Development Act or even the Apartment Ownership Act of any state. There are laws. These laws will stand. The bill recognizes this distinction and defines local authority in Clause 2C. Plots are covered under the bill, as I have explained. Completion certificate and occupation certificate are defined very separately. Resolve disputes in 6 months. Disputes, resolution also. Tyagiji said you resolve the dispute in 6 months. Bill provides to resolve the disputes in 60 days, Tyagiji. Yeah, and also he also mentioned about misleading advertisement also. The bill punishes misleading advertisements under Clause 12 of the bill. And bill also provides for promotional measures, grading of projects, grading of promoters in Clause 3.2b. In Clause 3.2, provided for use of appropriate construction material also, construction techniques also. Mr. Raju Gowda has given a good suggestion that with the new advent of the advanced technology, we have to codify all this and then send it to all the states. I'll be doing it. But at the end of it, sir, I am very happy that almost all people, I have the names of all the members, except my friends from the ADMK, ADMK, who raised the principal objection, which they thought it's right, but we are in disagreement with them. I only appeal to them also to see reason and see that you also support this bill, because the bill is need of the hour. The bill is need of the hour. I do agree there is still scope for improvement, but improvements can be done in future as and when we come to some definite conclusions and evolve a broad consensus, we can bring further changes also. Government is a continuous institution. What about rural areas? Class 3-1, second proviso gives power to the authority to register projects beyond municipal area, but within planning municipal area, within the planning area, in the interest of all the authorities, that also has been taken care. Sir, to the extent possible, whatever doubts were raised or concerns were raised, they are all addressed. I'm just coming.
Real estate business has become the most effective way to convert black money into white money. Does the government want it to promote in the name of promoting the real estate business?
Sir, I am aware of it. If you see that 70% of the project cost he has to put in bank, you cannot put black money in bank. I don't think it's allowed. So 70% of the money is being put. That means we are bringing money to the regular system. So let us also understand how the country functions and functioned up to now. Not because of this party or that party. There is a system now. Suddenly, if you then say that the rural people, you insist upon them also, you even 10,000, 20,000, you get a check and then only payments can be accepted. There will be practical problems also. But still, to the extent possible, we are trying to take care, see that illegal money or unaccounted money is also prohibited. That's why we brought this provision of 70%. With regard to the issue raised by Sri Rehman Khanji, with regard to disclose the size of the apartment in terms of carpet area, he was saying what will happen to the projects which are ongoing and which were already sold. About this, there is no clarity, I do admit. About that, there is no clarity. But I will definitely address that and bring it in the rules, because government has the power to make rules and communicate the same to the states.
Okay.
Sir, with this, I would like to thank all the.
लैंड के ऊपर इंक्रोच लैंड के ऊपर जो घर बन जाते हैं उसके लिए उसके अंदर अथॉरिटी भी सम्मिलित रहती है, उसके लिए आपके पास में क्या प्रोविजन है? क्योंकि उसके अंदर छोटे छोटे लोगों का पैसा लगा रहता है, सरकारी जमीनें होती है, वो मैनग्रोव की जमीन होती है, वो खेल के मैदान की जमीन होती है, वो उसके लिए क्या प्रोविजन है? मैंने पूछा था आपसे जो नई टेक्नोलॉजी है उस टेक्नोलॉजी का यूज करके आप अपने नक्शे कैसे पास करवाओगे?
ये एक इंक्रोच लैंड के बारे में, अनलेस यू गेट ए सर्टिफिकेट दैट द लैंड इज फ्री फ्रॉम एनकम्बरेंस, यू कैन नॉट गो फॉर अ प्रोजेक्ट. व्हाट इज हैपनिंग नाउ, वी आर सीइंग आफ्टर द बिल्डिंग्स आर कंस्ट्रक्टेड, आफ्टर सो मेनी थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग, समबडी इज रेजिंग ए लिटिगेशन. इट्स प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी, इट इज वर्क प्रॉपर्टी, इट इज टेम्पल प्रॉपर्टी. दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ लिटिगेशन आर गोइंग ऑन एंड दे आर from local court to Supreme Court.
These
litigations are pending and ordinary people are taken for a ride. Yeah. That's why he is supposed to provide a clear encumbrance certificate about the land, title of the land. Then only they will register it. Otherwise, they will not. One, with regard to... Please.
Let him complete. Very important. Okay. Put the question. No speech. Put the question only. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Sir.
Yeah, please. I think.
Us. There is a provision. Please.
No, please. That's okay. No. The, yes, yes.
के बारे में
आप क्या? No, you are asking second time. No.
No, no, sir. But he has not clarified on my subject.
Okay. What do you want to ask?
That put. Very important. See, this power to remove encroachments or power to stop unauthorized construction lies with the urban local body.
That is already
those
said.
Those officers who are supposed to take care of it, they sleep initially. After construction, some smart IAS officer comes and asks for demolition and all.
Okay.
That's why in my new urban development initiative, I made it mandatory that there has to be transparency and also accountability. The officer in whose area this unauthorized construction comes,
I think that's enough now.
He has to be held responsible.
Yes.
Sir, I am somewhat disappointed that the honorable minister any colorful rhymes.
No, you have to put question only.
So I would suggest to him that following his example, this bill is a pill that will not kill.
Okay, that's all. Okay. Yeah. All right. What is Shiva?
Sir, the bill makes registration compulsory to projects. The proposed land, if it exceeds only 1,000 square meters, or the apartments are 12 or 20, sir. But I would suggest to the 12, I would suggest to the minister, 1,000 square meters is equivalent to 10,000 square feet, sir. In 5,000 square feet, they can construct 10 apartments, and they can divide it into two and construct 20 apartments and need not register it, sir.
Yeah.
So I think if the minister could bring down the area
I think
of
that is a
land
valid,
to be proposed compulsory from 1,000 square meters, that would be helpful, sir. The standing committee has also recommended.
Earlier it was 1,000 square meters and 12 flats. Now it has been brought down to 500 square meters and then 8 flats. One. And the issue was already raised by Seljaji. I have responded also, sir. I read from the bill. Provided that if the appropriate government considers it necessary, it may reduce the threshold below 500 square meters or 8 apartments as the case may be, includes of all phases for exemption from registration under this Act. States have been given this power.
Okay, that is